Komal Da, as he was known to most of his friends, was no ordinary man. He was not only a renowned ethnomusicologist, but also much more. He was one of the pioneers in the documentation of performing arts in India. For more than 50 years, Komal Da researched and documented the performing arts of Rajasthan region. He has notable contributions to studies in many areas of folklore, in particular to study of musical instruments and oral traditions.
मेरे अध्ययन में जो सबसे अधिक महत्वपूर्ण बात है किसी भी चीज को अध्ययन करना चाहे देवी देवता की बात करनी हो चाहे लोकवादी की बात करनी हो चाहे लोक संगीत की बात करनी हो तो पहला मैं देखता हूँ कि मेरे परिवार के अंदर वो कौन सी चीज है और मैं परिवार के लोगों से कंफर्म कर सकता हूँ उस चीज को मेरे लिए सबसे बड़ा प्रमाण वही है कि जो प्रमाण मुझको अपने परिवार में अपने इर्द गिर्द रहने वालों के पास से मिलता है और वो मेरे अनुभव का भाग अगर है तो मुझे लगता है कि इससे मैं बहुत कुछ सीख पा रहा हूँ।
He recorded and archived thousands of hours of traditional Rajasthani music. The depth of his research stands out as an inspiration to others who aspire to document India's varied art heritage. They have been collecting and documenting folk songs, folk tales, proverbs from Rajasthan. Rupayan has also published folk tales and collected material by travelling to the remotest regions on foot. Today, his work has brought world recognition to folk artists like Langa and Manganyar singers.
कि जो मेरा ज्ञान है, वो ज्ञान इन लोगों के चरणों में बैठ के मुझे मिला। जिस गानों को ज्ञान को निर्धारित करके उसको एक रूप देने की कोशिश की है, उसके माध्यम से इस प्रकार के कार्य
When Sangeet Natak Academy started the Lok Utsav highlighting the various regional traditions of India, Komal Kothari played a vital role in bringing traditional maestros like Langa and Manganyar communities. Komal Da, the acknowledged doyen of Rajasthani culture, was the recipient of several national and international honours and awards. These include National Sangeet Natak Academy Fellowship, the Padma Shri, Hakim Khan Suri Award Foundation, Nahar Samman Puraskar, International Prince Claus Award, G.D. Birla Award, First Rao Sinha Award, and this year, in 2004, the highest civilian award, Padma Bhushan. The noted folklorist and one of the few exponents of oral traditions of history was working on an ambitious project of building an ethnographic museum, first of its kind planned anywhere in the country. Komalda asserted that he would have nothing of antique value in his museum. Ours is not going to be an ajayab ghar or the old curiosity halls like the ones set up by the royal families in the post-independence period in India.
Now the question of what type of museum, it has to do with ethnography. But vision-wise, what we tried to decide is that people living anywhere, in villages, specifically, but 70% or more than that percent lives in the villages. So they have nature around them, so they have land, they have plants, they have animals, domestic elements, forest elements, they have trees and birds and everything around. They construct something like their houses, they wear some type of shoes, they eat something. Now these subjects will form the part of museum. It will not be very exotic material, very aesthetic objects and beautiful objects with lot of history and like that. That we will not deal. We'll deal with absolutely contemporary life and whatever people are creating for their own day-to-day needs.
The dream project of this new museum would come up amidst natural ambience with hills, water, sand, plants, grass, abandoned stone mines in eco-friendly atmosphere.